If this was a series about male villains, Darth Vader, one of the most iconic bad guys in cinema history, would be top 10 for sure. But since I'm reviewing female villains, there are not that many to choose from in the Star Wars franchise. Female leads have become more prominent over the past decade, notably Jyn Erso in Rogue One, who proved to be a fantastic action heroine. However, female villains are rare in this galaxy, and those that have featured are not especially memorable. A shout out to Solo for having a masked rebel pirate who turns out to be female, with a voice disguised as usual, but she couldn't really be considered evil. We also get a second reveal that involves a seemingly sweet female turned Sith agent, but it's a one-time appearance and we're still waiting on a true female badass. Okay, so perhaps she's not terrible, but people expected so much more from Gwendoline Christie as a statuesque silver stormtrooper. Off the back of a memorable role as Brienne of Tarth in Game of Thrones, Villainess fans understandably had high expectations. Then The Force Awakens released in 2015 and we got to see Phasma do, well, not very much. Armadai candy is not what we expected. In fact, Phasma gets captured by the heroes without a fight, and we're left with a very unsatisfying off-screen resolution.
You can't be so stupid as to think this will be easy. My troops will storm this block and kill you all.
I disagree. What do we do with her?
Is there a garbage chute? Trash compactor?
Yeah, there is.
The good news is Phasma actually gets to be a badass villainess in Episode 8 and didn't get the off-screen death we all feared. Get the feeling she was reintroduced because of fan backlash. This time Phasma is a threat, though unfortunately absent for most of the film. The armoured silver trooper engages in combat, fires blasters and fights hand to hand with a hero Finn in one final confrontation.
You're a bug in the system.
Let's go, Chromedome.
Come on!
Hey!
Two very brief, barely honourable mentions, and even that feels generous. So there's not much competition when it comes to Star Wars villainesses, and Zam almost wins by default. That said, there are a number of memorable moments in Episode 2, even though Zam is a minor character who only lasts the first quarter or so of the movie. Zam is a bounty hunter working for the bad guys who want to take over the galaxy. There's no limit to their ambition, and anyone who's seen the original trilogy will know they succeed, which makes the hero's efforts moot, but they have to fill up three movies somehow and make it a struggle for the dark side. Technically, Zam works for Jango Fett, father of Boba from The Empire Strikes Back, and she's really a foot soldier doing it for presumably credits. The villainess gets an explosive introduction when she attempts to assassinate Senator Padme Amidala on her arrival to Coruscant. But when the bomb kills the Senator's decoy instead, Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi and his apprentice Anakin Skywalker are assigned to protect her. The assassin's not about to be deterred that easily though.
I hit the ship, but they used a decoy.
We'll have to try something more subtle this time, Sam. My client is getting impatient. Take these. Be careful, they're very poisonous. Sam, there can be no mistakes this time.
So being subtle in this universe means attempting to kill Padme with poisonous parasites. After the Jedi arrive in the nick of time to save the Imperial Senator, a habit of heroes, we get one of the best scenes in the movie as the two main characters pursue the would-be assassin in an airborne speeder chase. This is quite a long sequence, and the great thing about it is the quarry proves to be slippery and dangerous and a match for the pursuing Jedi. In a sky chase, Sam is revealed to be a changeling, a humanoid creature able to alter her appearance. And eventually the villainess is forced into a crash landing and we get a final confrontation in a bar. This sequence is somewhat disappointing as Sam remains in the same human form throughout. I'm assuming changelings can take on any appearance, so would have liked to have seen a bit more deception here. After that rather tame final confrontation, the villainess gets an okay demise, but nothing special.
And who hired you?
It's just a job.
Who hired you? Tell us. Tell us now!
It was a bounty hunter who called.
What a shame! Slime!
That sets up the main plot of the film, and overall Sam ranks low on my list because of a limited contribution. Until we get anything better though, Leeanna Walsman can claim she's played the best female villain in a Star Wars movie.